Hey guys, it's Anna, and today I'm talking about managing multiple calendars within Google Calendar. So the first thing to know is down the left-hand side, your calendars are organized into two sections, My Calendars and Other Calendars. That's just what it sounds like. My calendars are calendars that I own, and other calendars are other calendars that I have access to. If you are a Google Classroom user, any class where you are the main instructor is going to be listed under My Calendars, and any class where you are a student is going to be listed under Other Calendars. The first thing to know is about the color coding. So Google Calendar is really set up so that you can combine multiple calendars together. Maybe you've got your work calendar, your personal calendar like I have here, the staff calendar, the student calendar. You might have your own child's soccer schedule calendar that was shared by the coach. So it's designed so you can have a lot of different calendars and each one is color coded. So these colors correspond to the colors over here on the left. It's not really set up for you to color code your own events on one calendar for different categories. You can do that, but that's not really the vision for how Google has set up calendar colors. Something to know is that you can edit these colors. So if you have two that are too close to each other, you can hover over the name of any of these calendars to get some more options, which is the three dots. And you can change the color of any one of these calendars by just selecting a different color there. Something to note about that is that you are changing the colors personally for yourself. You are not changing the color for other users. So if you were to go onto your Google Classroom calendar and change it to blue, it doesn't mean that all the students will see it in blue. Calendar colors are specific to the user. The next thing to know is that if you're using a lot of different Google calendars, sometimes your view can get kind of cluttered here. So you can control which events that you're looking at one time. You can uncheck any calendar to not see that calendar and check it back when you're ready for it to show again. If you really need to focus in on one particular calendar, you can hover over the name, click the three dots and choose display this only, and it will hide everything else except for that one calendar. Do notice that there is not any option to go back to your previous view. If you do display this only, you're going to have to go back and manually click all the ones that you had selected before to bring them back up. All right, another thing to know is that you can hide calendars. So if your list is getting too cluttered, you don't want to get rid of the calendar so that you can never see it again, but you want to hide it so that it's not in your list. You can hover over any of these calendars, whether it's My or Other, click the three dots and choose Hide from List. And again, you can do the same thing up here. Click the three dots and choose Hide from List just to unclutter your list of calendars a little bit. If you ever need to get back one of those calendars that you've hidden, this is a little bit roundabout. You might not think to do this, but how you do that is hover over any other calendar, click the menu and choose Settings and Sharing. And it's going to show you all of your calendars here on the left, including ones that are hidden. So all these with an I with a slash to them are hidden. I can click that icon to unhide that calendar in my list and it will appear in my list again. Okay. So you may at some point find that you can't see a calendar for one of your Google Classrooms. It could be that you've hidden it. So go in and do settings and sharing and see if that calendar is still in the list but hidden. You can unhide it. One thing that you can also do is unsubscribe from something. So if you don't want to see this calendar anymore, you can click the X next to a calendar to just completely delete it off your list, and it will give you a warning. Are you sure that you want to do this? You won't have access to this anymore. So be careful about that, because you'll have to get the link again and add it back if it's somebody else. And if it's your calendar up here, you're actually deleting that calendar. If you're the only one that has access to it. So be careful with clicking the X. It's probably best to hide it unless you're sure you're never going to need it again. with other calendars, when you click the X, that's actually called unsubscribing. So the calendar will still appear. Like here it says other people will with access can continue to use it. But you're just unsubscribing from it to remove it from your list. All right. Then I wanted to show you how to add calendars. There's a couple different ways. One you might want to check out. Next to other calendars here, click the plus and do browse calendars of interest. And what it has is just some already set calendars that you may want to add to yours. So first of all, birthdays, this is tied to your Google contacts. So if you don't have any contacts saved in Google, this won't do anything. But if you've got contacts listed and they have birthdays, they will show on your calendar. I like to turn on holidays in the United States. You can also browse holidays from other places if you would like. But it's nice to have those automatically appear on my calendar. You could also add religious holidays. Phases of the moon is at the bottom. But notice there are sports calendars here, and you can actually choose your favorite team. So if I do football and choose NCAA, I can actually scroll down. It's going to give me a long list and choose my favorite team from the list, and then I'll be able to see that all of that team's events. So if I check Georgia Bulldogs, it says calendar added. I'm going to click back from the settings to go back to my regular calendar. And notice here now I have the Bulldogs at the Volunteers listed on my calendar. So that's a cool thing that you can add by doing the plus and browse calendars of interest. Next, you can add a calendar from an embed. So for instance, here I am on the Parkview Advisement page. And if I scroll down to where the calendar is embedded here, notice in the corner, it has plus Google Calendar. Anytime you see this, you can click that to add that calendar to your calendars, to add it to your list. So when I click that, it's going to open a new window. It's going to bring up my own calendars for whatever account I'm logged into. And then it will say, do you want to add this calendar? So just click add. And it has added those events in. I noticed that color is a little close to something else I've already got on here. So I'm going to click here and change the colors. Let's try this. So it stands out a little bit more. And again, you can unsubscribe from a calendar you've added by clicking the X, and that's going to make it disappear. Lastly, you may get a calendar added to you, sent to you as a link instead of having the embed here. If you have a link, just make sure you're signed into your correct account and then click that link, and it will bring up that same view we saw when I clicked the advisement calendar link there. It'll bring something up that tells you the name of the calendar and asks you, do you want to add it or not? So that's the basics of managing multiple calendars within Google Calendar. Let me know if you have any questions that I can answer. Thanks.